What rule? All of you, I think, might be knowing this rule. This is a very simple rule which you have studied in maths also, which is, what is this rule called? What is this rule called, students? Not of A union B is equal to not A intersection not B, and the reverse of that also. There's some name. Yeah, De Morgan's law, correct. Yeah, so this is basically De Morgan's law only. Right. So this is De Morgan's law. So this also you can apply in order to reduce them further. And the other rule which you will apply is not of for every x, px would be equivalent to there exists x not px. So basically, if you are taking the negation of universal quantifier, it will become existential. If you take the not of there exist, it will become for all. Okay, so if you take the not of for all, it will become there exist. If you take the not of there exist, it will become for all. Okay, so they are basically complements of each other, right? So not of this complete expression, if you do, the complete expression is for every x px, so it will be equal to there exists some x not of px, right? And if you take the negation of there exists x px, that will be equivalent to for every x not of px. So these are the four rules which you have to use, and then you have to simplify this expression further. So now you use these rules. Are you able to get the last two rules, students? Are the last two rules clear? Okay, fine. Okay, fine. So now you apply these rules further. So where you will apply the rule? So basically, you will apply the rule where you are having not of A union B or not of A intersection B. So just apply this rule. So if you take the negation of Roman X intersection no X comma Marcus in the LHS, so that will become not of Roman X union with not of no X comma Marcus. So in the LHS, if you see, it is negation of A intersection B, where A is Roman X and B is no X comma Marcus. So you take the De Morgan's law, you apply, and you will get not of Roman X union with not of no X comma Marcus. That's how you simplify the LHS. Now you come to the RHS. In the RHS, you have a negation sign before the there exists Z symbol, right? So the LHS is of that negation. The negation would be applied to there exists some z hate y comma z. So it's all in negation. So you take the negation of that. So the there exists z will become for every z, right? So there exists z, if you take the negation of that, it will become for every z. And hate y z, if you take the negation of that, it will become not of hate y z. Fine. So it will become for every z such that not of hate y z. And any other simplification possible? I don't think so. Any other thing is applicable over here. So this is the simplified expression after the second step. Are you able to get this? How we did in the second step? Got it, students? Okay, fine. Then the third step. So the third step is standardize the variables so that each quantifier binds a unique variable. Okay, so here you have to see that every quantifier is binding a unique variable. If it is not binding a unique variable, you have to use a different variable for each and every object. So basically, if it is the same object, you have to use the same variable. If it is a different object, you have to use a different variable. So if you see in this expression, all variables are already standardized. Why? Because you are using different variables for different objects. For example, if you see here, X is a Roman and X is knowing Marcus. So this will imply that X is hating Caesar, and otherwise he's thinking crazy that X is thinking crazy about Y. So we are talking about the same object. So that is why we will write it like X only. So we are talking about the same object basically. So that will be all X's, right? And when we are talking about some other person, like we are talking about some other person who is hating some other third person, so we have to use different symbols. So that is why we have used Y and Z for those two different people, right? So we have already used different symbols. for binding different variables. So this step is already taken care of. So we just quickly skip this step, because if we have not used the different symbols for different objects, then we should use different symbols for different objects. That is what this step says. So each quantifier should actually be related to a different variable. So we have three quantifiers related to X, Y, and Z, which are different objects and different variables. So it's already taken care of. So we go to the fourth step now. So fourth step is move all the quantifiers to the left of the formula. So move all the quantifiers to the left of the formula. So you just move them. So you see here, your quantifiers, whatever are present, you just have to move them towards the left. Okay. So you move the for every X, for every Y, and for every Z, you move them towards the left hand side, and you will get the remaining formula on the right hand side. So you just move them on the left hand side. So you'll get this. So all the quantifiers will come on the left hand side. So for every X, for every Y, for every Z, and the remaining formula is there after these quantifiers. So this is the remaining formula. If you see here, you just have to write the remaining formula together, just after removing the quantifiers. Okay. So we have just shifted the quantifiers to the left, and this is what we get. So this is called as a prenext normal form. This means that a prefix of quantifiers followed by a quantifier-free expression. So there's a prefix of quantifiers, and then we have a quantifier-free expression. So this is called as a prenext normal form after the fourth step. Okay. Quantifiers. So how do we eliminate the existential quantifiers? We have to eliminate them using a Skolem function. Okay. So what is a Skolem function? If you have, suppose you have this expression, there exists some Y such that president of Y, and you want to remove this existential quantifier on Y. Okay. So how you will remove this existential quantifier on Y? What you will assume is that you will replace it with the expression president S1, and S1 is called as a Skolem function. So basically, this is a function which will produce a value that will satisfy the president predicate. Okay. So what is this actually existential quantifier means? Existential quantifier means that there is some value which will satisfy this president, right? So we assume that there is a function S1 which will produce that value. Okay. So this function is called a Skolem function. It will produce the desired value which will satisfy this predicate president. Okay. So this is basically a characteristic of Skolem functions, that they are able to produce a value which will satisfy that particular predicate. So it will produce some Y which will be a president. So in that case, this existential quantifier we can remove, and we can replace this Y by the S1 function. So it's called as a Skolem function. And then how do we do for the other, if you have a universal quantifier also within the scope of an existential quantifier? So then how you remove this existential quantifier? So that also we will study. So basically, I will repeat this fifth step again in the next class. It's already time. So I'll repeat this step in the next class. Divya, are you there? Divya, can you take the attendance? Okay, Divya, please take the attendance. Done. Okay, you can mail me that attendance. And students, I hope all of you are aware that we are going to have a quiz on this Friday. I have posted the quiz notice on Google Classroom. Are you aware of the quiz? Yeah. Okay, fine. So there will be a quiz of 20 marks on this Friday at 4 p.m. Okay. So it will be of 40 minutes, just like we did in the CPP. In the last semester, in the CPP also, we had a similar quiz. The same kind of quiz. I mean, the similar criteria, similar pattern quiz of 20 marks objective type on this Friday. Okay, that will become your internal assessment marks. Tomorrow is holiday. Why? Tomorrow is a holiday? I don't know that thing. Is it a holiday? No, I don't think it is a holiday. Yeah, Vasant Panchmi. But is it a holiday tomorrow? Is anybody confirmed about this thing? I am not sure. Divya? Acha, in the calendar it is written that it's a holiday. Okay, let me check this out. If it is a holiday, I will let you know. But otherwise, it is by default, it is not. But I mean, I will check this out and let you know. If there is no class, I mean, if it's a holiday, then I will let you know. According to the calendar, let me check out in the calendar and confirm this thing. Okay, so on Friday, we have a quiz at 4 p.m. students. And one more thing, students, I just wanted to take an informal feedback from you because we have completed almost 18 or 19 lectures. So students, can you tell me you are able to understand in the lectures and how is it going? Anything from your side which you want to tell me? How is it going? Anybody, are you able to understand? Yeah, we have completed almost 5 chapters. I mean, this is the 5th chapter going on. Okay, and after, I mean, 3 or 4 classes more, after that we'll be finishing the basics of AI. I mean, the basic part of AI, then we'll go to some advanced topics. Okay, so basically we have finished almost 5 chapters. This is the 5th chapter going on. So 50% approx, yeah, you can say that thing. It's like 40% now, but in the next 3-4 classes, it will be around 50%. Okay. And then the remaining 50%, we will be covering in the next 10 or 11 classes because that is advanced topics. So these topics are actually more important than the advanced topics because this forms the basics of AI. So that is why I'm devoting more time to this part. And then the advanced part, that is basically you will be able to understand once you get this all. Okay. Any other thing which you want to ask students? Anything which you want to give as a feedback? Are you able to understand? Okay, so how, okay, and what about the speed? Is it going slow or fast or is it okay? What about the speed? Okay, fine. Okay, fine. So, fine. If anything, any concern is there, then please let me know, students. Anything you want to ask or any concern is there regarding the course, anything, any doubt, please ask. Okay, Krishna is asking, will we have our classes after midterm too, or will we have only up till 12th March? Up till 12th March only, as of now. Okay, so up till 12th March only, because after that your exams will be there. So after that you will be coming offline, I mean you will be coming in the campus. So then your pending labs would be held and then your exams of mid-sem and end-sem would be held. No classes. Okay, so your last class is up till 12th March. So that is why actually we have, no. After 12th March, we don't have classes. No, there is, as per now, whatever information we have, we don't have any class before the end term. All classes are finishing up till 12th March only, as per my knowledge. Okay, so as per whatever we have information we have received till now. But actually, it is a short semester because only 2 months. We started on 11th January and we are going to finish on 12th March. So that's only 2 months. So we have to skip some topics. Some topics we will not be able to cover because classes are less and it's a short semester, right? It's even less than the last semester. Last semester we had three months, but in this semester we have only 2 months. I think last semester for CPP we had 3 months, right? Almost 2.5 months we had, but here we have 2 months. So we will see. But for most of the important topics I'll cover. Okay, last semester also 2 months, right? But most of the important topics I'll cover. Some of the topics which might have been covered in the normal regular classes, we may have to skip some side topics. The main topics will all be covered in the class. Anything else? Okay, fine, students. One more thing, your textbook, the book which you can refer is Rich and Knight for this course. Rich and Knight. Let me type. Please see the chat box, students. Rich and Knight is your book, is your prescribed textbook for this course which you can study. And there is another book which we call as Russell and Norvig. Just see the chat box, Russell and Norvig. So these are the two textbooks from which you can get about this course. And other is and one more thing is there. I have also written a textbook on artificial intelligence, and that is basically by Wiley Publishers. So Wiley Publishers. So this book, I actually wanted to tell you this thing, that this book, which is my publication, I mean, I'm the author of that one. And this book also contains all the content of Rich and Knight and Russell and Norvig, plus my own additional content, because I was teaching this subject from the last 6-7 years when I was in my PhD. So I have developed some kind of examples and numericals, which I have basically, whatever examples I have taken in the heuristic search techniques, those were by my own examples. Okay, so those are there. All of them are there in this book, which is by Wiley Publishers. So if you want, you can have access to this book also. Hard copies are available. I think in Jaipur also, Wiley was telling me that in Jaipur also, in the store in Tonk Road, there is a store. I think the store name was this Ashirwad store. That's there on Tonk Road, I think. So in that one, I think you will get this book. Otherwise, from the next week onwards, this will be available on Amazon also as an ebook. So if you want, you can buy this book also, and you'll get all the content basically. And one more thing, whatever I'm teaching, the slides, those slides, basically, I prepared it mostly from some text from Rich and Knight, and some mostly the content is from my own book only. Okay. So that is it. So you have three options with you, students. You can take this Rich and Knight, Russell and Norvig. Otherwise, this is my AI book. That is also there. This book is actually a comprehensive book of all the above plus some additional content. So it depends on you what you want. But these could be your preferences if you want some background knowledge of whatever topics I have taught. Okay. Anything which you want to ask, students? About the textbooks. Yeah, Nitin. Yeah, these techniques are still in use actually. We are using these techniques, but people have developed actually more advanced heuristics. Studying them, we are doing them, but we have actually developed on top of them, we have added some things, so some advancements have come, but we need to understand the basics first. So that is why these techniques we are studying, but of course we have achieved some advancements over these techniques currently. Okay, but we need to understand the basics. So that is why this course. Anything else? Okay then, students. Okay then, thank you all of you. We'll meet tomorrow. I'll confirm to you, Divya, about the holiday. Okay, thank you all of you. Okay, thank you.